I'm Levina Diego. I'm 86 years old. I was born in the Philippines. I come here to Guam. I'm how many? 60 years now here in Guam, but cannot speak Chamorro. Can understand a little bit because the relative is. I have two kids. They're grown already. One is a photographer and one is a ATM technician. And I'm a widow. Critical. That was, they said, it is a super typhoon that came today.
Yeah.
That 16 days I was here, 16 days after the typhoon, I arrived Guam. So I live in a small house. The owner is the old timer here, the Rojas family. They own even this place. I bought this from them.
Yeah.
The Rojas family.
Yeah, yeah.
Their house is, you know, that big lake over there, that's where I live.
Oh, but then you won't.
Because the this is a hospital of the U.S. Navy, this place after. And then the officers made three small houses down there in that, like that lake where you see.
Yeah,
yeah, there are three small houses for the officers. And doctors, I think, maybe they're doctors. It's a one-bedroom house. Everything's there.
Oh.
So they just walk coming to this place over here.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's when I first come to Guam.
Oh.
And the house that we rent is, the side is broken, there's a big hole, so we just buy plywood and, you know, cover it, and then the roof is, we change the roof with tin roofing,
yeah.
And that's where we live. For 5 years I was there. And my neighbors are Palawan.
Oh, so there are Palawans here?
Oh, yeah. Even when I transferred over here, my neighbors are still Palawan.
Mm.
Boy, at night, they play, they sang, they drank, everything. They're noisy, but we don't have trouble. Oh, I don't have American neighbor. No American neighbor, only Palawan and Chamorro and Leo Filipinos. You know, we're all in the Asia and the Pacific.
Mm-hmm.
Most likely we have the same, you know, in culture.
Oh, okay.
It's not very much
different.
We're really, you know, we love our family. We love our neighbor. We don't fight. We argue. We give each other, you know, what I have, I give. What they have, they give me. When they go fishing, they give us fish. You know.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever they have in the trees, they're like the Chamorro, you could pick their lemon. We pick their artists, they have artists, they're blame right there.
Oh.
Yeah, and then even the kamuti. Whatever they have, we have, you know, they're not stingy, nobody's stingy.
Yeah.
No problem. Yeah. That transportation is very hard. I live down in that place I told you where they have the big lagoon, not lagoon,
yeah,
but you call that drainage, right?
Yeah.
That's where we live. So I was pregnant, I have to walk. I was working in Aganya. I have to walk from that place to Marine Drive. So that's where we, you know, look for taxi.
Yeah, yeah.
Because there's nobody, not like now, now it's already good. Before,
yeah,
very hard. Transportation is very hard. Oh, I think I raised him good. Because I'm not, all I will tell him is to fear God, number one. Love God and fear God. And then I told him that treat your friends as your family. So they're very good. They're like the friends of my children are Chamorro, and Filipino,
yeah,
and Palawan, and Vietnamese, and no, see, Arnie, my youngest son is the one that got the most Even up to now.
Yeah.
Even up to now, Palawan, friend, they come to my house. They are very good to me. They call me auntie. I was a Catholic, born a Catholic, and I will die a Catholic.
Oh.
You will be judged according to your own labor. So no matter what religion you have,
yeah,
if you are doing wrong, nothing. Now, you know, if you are doing good, even you don't have religion, as you go to the what God says, God words, you know, no matter what religion you are, because it says in the Bible, you will be judged according to your own labor. That is in Matthew. Every Sunday, my husband bring me to Junya, the two churches, the twin churches over there.
Yeah, yeah.
When I first come, that is where we go every Sunday. When I first come to Guam, the typhoon, as I told you, I was the one that cleaned the typhoon remnants of the Madeline's store. I was paid 90 cents an hour. 90 cents an hour, and I have to receive my paycheck every week.
So not 90 every 2 weeks,
weekly. Oh, 90 cents. Oh, 90 cents. And my husband is receiving $1.15. And he was already working with Jones and Guerrero. 90 cents per hour plus every week is that paid. And then I have an American, what do you call that? Sex clerk too, that is working in the Navy. And you won't believe, I thought I won't survive. Every day we eat hamburger.
I love hamburger.
Hamburger and French fry. Oy. I thought, boy, hamburger every day, lunch, hamburger, but that is life. And I don't know how to drive. And who is going to buy food for me? So I have to give my money first. That's our lunch every day, hamburger.